When it comes to logo design, at some point in the process, we will need to take our ideas and bring them to life and finalize them on the computer. When developing your logo designs on a computer, the best method is to develop vector artwork. Now, some of you watching this may already know what vector artwork is, but for those who don't, I won't go into too much detail, but simply put, vector artwork is created using anchor points, which can be edited and fine-tuned to perfectly craft your artwork. Vector artwork also allows you to scale your designs up and down as much as possible without degrading your artwork. Programs like Photoshop work with pixels as bitmap images, which make it really hard to scale up and down and maintain quality of your artwork. For this reason, we should only use vector-based creative tools to develop logos and not pixel-based bitmap software like Photoshop. Now, this is not to say we won't use programs like Photoshop later in the process, but when developing logo designs initially on the computer, it's best to use vector-based programs. In this video, I'm going to discuss some software tools you can consider for logo design. So, let's get into it. So, as mentioned earlier, we really want to use vector-based creative software tools to develop our logo design. And the best tools I would recommend right now is either Adobe Illustrator or Affinity Designer. Adobe Illustrator has been around for a long time and is the industry standard for creating vector-based artwork and comes as part of the Adobe Creative Cloud Suite. On this course, I'll be using Adobe Illustrator to demonstrate how I develop my logo design ready to present to the client. Now, Adobe Illustrator is also available as an app on the iPad, which makes it really easy to use the pencil to draw with. So if you want to use an iPad as part of your design process, as well as a desktop computer, you can use Adobe Illustrator. Now, as great as Adobe Illustrator is, to use it, you need a subscription, which to some is not accessible. So another option you can consider is Affinity Designer. Affinity Designer is an up-and-coming program that can be acquired for a one-off fee instead of having to subscribe to a monthly plan. I describe Affinity Designer like a Photoshop Illustrator hybrid, and allows you to edit photographs as well as build and craft vector artwork. If you're looking to use an alternative to Adobe Illustrator, you can consider using Affinity Designer. The vector tools in Affinity work much the same as Illustrator. As I demonstrate how to develop my logo designs in Illustrator, you will be able to follow along in Affinity Designer. And another great thing about Affinity is that it's also available on the iPad. Like Adobe Illustrator, if you have a tablet computer and want to use your Apple Pencil to develop your vector logo designs, Affinity is a good option on the iPad. Now, there are other software tools and apps on the market, and if you use something else, just make sure it's vector-based. But for this course, I would personally recommend you use these two. Adobe Illustrator, because it's industry standard and available on both desktop and tablet. And Affinity, because it too is available on desktop and tablet, though comes with a more accessible one-off price tag. For the rest of this course, I will be demonstrating how to develop logo design artwork using Adobe Illustrator. But if you're using Affinity, you should be able to follow along just fine. So up to this point on the course, we have covered phase one of the design process, where we researched and discovered some really cool areas to base our logo design on. Then we moved into phase two, where we thought about ideas, sketched some concepts, and then generated some logo designs. With our design in a good place, it's now time to move into phase three, visual artwork and design, where we will use creative software tools to bring our concept logo designs to life, with the goal to finalize them ready to present to the client. In the next video, we are going to kick off phase three, and I'm going to demonstrate just how you can take your sketches and scamps and turn them into vector artwork in Adobe Illustrator. So see you in the next video.